Hello! In this video, we'll talk about using names in formulas and circular references. But before that, I'll make a little trick to replace the acronym with a sentence. And at the end of the video, I'll make another important trick to enter the formula easily. So, I want you to watch this video to the end. But before starting, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. Are you ready? Let's begin. I want to write a long sentence like the name of the company by using acronym. Like here, I want to write Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. just by writing PAA. Go to the File tab, Options, Proofing, Autocorrect Options, under Replace field, write PAA. Under Width field, write Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. Add. OK. If I write in any cell PAA, Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. will be displayed. Note that this trick will be applied in Word and PowerPoint also. If I write PAA in a Word document, Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. will be displayed. If I want PAA to be displayed, just press Ctrl and Z after write it. I have another way, but I can use it just in this file. I can use name. Defined names can be created and used in almost any way. They can represent numeric constants, such as tax rates, text constants, such as company name, absolute, relative, or mixed cell or range references. Formulas. Let's make a text constant name that represents the company name. To do that, go to the Formula tab, Define Name. In the Name field, I write PAA. In Refers To field, I write Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. OK. In any cell in this file, just write equals PAA. Pioneer Advertising Agency Inc. will be displayed. Defined name can be created in many ways in Excel. The easiest way is to highlight the cell or range of cells to be named and then type the desired name in the range box on the formula bar. For example, select G1 cell. In the range box, write tax rate without spaces. Note that the name mustn't include spaces. Press Enter. Note now that F1 cell's name in the range box is F1, but G1 cell's name is tax rate. In any cell, if I write equals tax rate 0.3 will be displayed. I have another way to define names. Let me select range A5, F15. Go to the Formula tab, Create from Selection. Here we'll choose top row and left column. Press Name Manager to preview the names. Note that names must begin with a letter, backslash, or underscore. No spaces are allowed in a defined name. Names that resemble cell references cannot be used. Single letters cannot be used for names. Names can contain up to 255 characters and are not case sensitive. Now we can use the names in the formulas. In B8, that represents gross profit, we write equals net sales minus cost of goods sold. The result will appear in all cells in the range. Repeat the same steps for income from operations. Note that income from operations equals gross profit minus operating expenses. Again, income before income tax equals income from operations plus other revenues and gains minus other expenses and losses. Income tax equals income before income tax multiplied by the tax rate. Finally, net income equals income before income tax minus income tax. If I want the income tax is 30% of the net income, what shall I do? Let's try to write. Income tax equals net income multiplied by the tax rate. Excel will give me an error message that says, Microsoft Excel cannot calculate a formula. There is a circular reference in an open workbook, but the references that cause it cannot be listed for you. Try editing the last formula you entered or removing it with the end document. To solve this problem, go to the File tab, Options, Formulas. Select Enable Iterative Calculation. Okay, we know that the results will be displayed. Now to fill the totals, press on F6, press on Control while pressing on F7, F9 and F12. Alt and Enter. All totals will be displayed. That's all for today. If you like this video, please share it to benefit as many people as possible. See you soon.